Let's start by drawing two diagrams. We have here the short-run equilibrium for both the industry and the firm under perfect competition. Now, both parts of the diagram have the same scale on the vertical axis, and that is of price. However, on the horizontal axis, they have totally different scales. For example, if the horizontal axis for the firm were to be measured in, let's say, thousands of units, the horizontal axis for the whole industry might be measured in millions or tens of millions of units, depending on the number of firms in the industry. So let's then examine the determination of price, output, and profit. The price is determined in the industry by the interaction of demand and supply in the industry. Now remember how the equilibrium is obtained in the industry? At a price higher than this, there will be a surplus and prices will be driven downwards because producers want to get rid of the surplus, hence lower prices. At a price lower than the equilibrium price, what happens is that consumers bid up the price due to a shortage and prices can only stop changing at the equilibrium price. So the firm faces a horizontal demand curve at this price, and we have already explained why it can't sell above or below. It can sell all it produces, all it can produce at the market price P, but nothing above. And the firm will maximize profits when the marginal cost equals to the marginal curve, which we have explained already, that the marginal revenue curve is also the demand curve, is also the average revenue curve, it is also the price. And this happens at output Q, where the marginal cost equals the marginal revenue, and that is a profit maximizing price, quantity. And since the firm has only one price at every quantity, the marginal revenue, like I said, will be equal to the price. So hence, the firm produces at MC equals to MR, which is equals to AR, which is equals to DD, demand curve, which is equals to P. But what about profit? Well, there are three possible scenarios you can illustrate in a short run. If the firm's AC dips below the AR curve at a profit maximizing point Q, then the firm will earn supernormal profit. So supernormal profit per unit of Q is the vertical difference between AR and AC at Q. And a total supernormal profit is simply the vertical distance times the quantity. Vertical distance times the quantity, which gives this rectangle here. What happens if the firm cannot make a profit at any level of output? Well, this situation will occur if AC is above the AR at all points. This is illustrated here in this case. And the firm still produces at a profit-maximizing price where MC equals to MR. In this case, however, since the profit is negative, we are producing at a loss-minimizing, or rather you can say negative profit-maximizing to minimize the loss. So profit-maximizing, loss-minimizing, same thing. The loss is represented by the rectangle, and the firm is earning subnormal profits. Now, of course, the firm can make normal profits. That's when its AC is equal to the AR at a profit-maximizing point. So there are three scenarios in a short run. In a short run, the firm's supply curve, not the industry's, will be the marginal cost curve. Why? A supply curve shows how much will be supplied at each price. It relates quantity to price. The marginal cost curve relates quantity to marginal cost. But under perfect competition, since your P equals to MR and MR equals to AC, your quantity is related to the price also by the MC curve. So, P is always equals to MC in this case. Now, what about an industry? The industry supply curve is simply the sum of the individual firm supply curves. Take, for example, this firm. It is able to supply 30 units of Apple at $1 each. So if the industry has, let's say, 1,000 firms, then it simply means that the industry will be able to supply 30,000 Apples at $1 each. It's that simple.